Hi, and welcome to the channel. In this video, we'll be comparing the performance of the RedMagic 10 Pro against the RedMagic 9 using the synthetic benchmark 3DMark. Specifically, we'll focus on the Solar Bay and Wildlife Extreme tests, which are run multiple times over a 20-minute period. I tested both devices with Diablo mode on and off several times, but I can confidently say that there was no noticeable difference. This is because both phones automatically detect the benchmark and push their performance to the maximum to deliver optimal results. Now let's check what we got. The Solar Bay stress test shows how a device performs under longer periods running a ray-traced, heavy gaming workload, and as we can see on the image. The RedMagic 10 Pro, at its best cycle, scored 12,016, while the RedMagic 9 Pro scored 8,677, showing a 38% performance increase. Additionally, efficiency improved by 10%, reaching up to 89%. These are excellent results for this benchmark. If we evaluate the performance and monitoring data, we can see that the 10 Pro drained about 4% more battery. However, the temperatures remained similar, and the 10 Pro achieved roughly 12 more FPS. Now it is time to move to the wildlife stress test that doesn't focus on ray tracing. Instead, over 20 cycles, it simulates mobile games designed for longer, more immersive experiences. Now, let's take a look at the results. The RedMagic 10 Pro, at its best cycle, scored 25,641, while the RedMagic 9 Pro scored 18,870, showing a 36% performance increase. Efficiency also improved by 5%, reaching 85%. While this is a solid improvement, it's slightly less than the results from the previous test. I'd also like to mention that during this test, I occasionally noticed the RedMagic 10 Pro stability dropping to approximately 70% or lower. This indicates that there's still room for improvement in ensuring more consistent performance since it never happened on the 9 Pro. Finally, if we evaluate the performance and monitoring data, we can see that the 10 Pro consumed the same amount of battery. However, it maintained lower temperatures and achieved over 40 FPS, which is quite remarkable. So, as you've seen from the results, there's about a 30 to 40% performance increase, though it's not always consistent. The Snapdragon 8 Elite is undoubtedly a powerhouse, but there's still room for optimization. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more mobile gaming content. See you in the next one.